So this is Khurram Nasir and you are watching Optometry with Khurram with me, and today's topic is about the amblyopia. We will discuss that either amblyopia is more lethal, more dangerous or more symptomatic in myopia or in hypermetropia. But before learning about this topic, you need to know about the definition, the clinical definition of amblyopia. We have a detailed playlist in terms of amblyopia, like the definition of amblyopia, the clinical definition of amblyopia, the pathophysiology and onset of amblyopia, the different types of amblyopia and treatment and management, sense of the different modes of treatment and management of amblyopia at Optometry with Khurram. The link is in the description, you can watch if you want. And this specifically, this video is about the effects of amblyopia in myopic patient or in hyperopic patient. So first of all, we will discuss about the definition, the layman definition of amblyopia. You know very well that if there is no any structural abnormality inside the eyeball, your cornea is fine, your lens is fine, the whole eyeball, the whole media is fine, and there is no any abnormality in the visual system, but still vision is lost inside the eyeball without any structural abnormality, then that condition is called the amblyopia. And if we talk about the clinical definition of amblyopia, if there is two Snellen line difference between the both eyes, then that condition is called, the amblyopia. But there is a detailed video on diagnosis of amblyopia, that how we can diagnose the amblyopia, right? You can watch, the link is in the description, you can watch if you want, that how can we diagnose the amblyopia. How can we differentiate that this patient is of amblyopia and this patient is of a normal refractive error, right? So let's continue our specific topic. And first of all, we discuss about the myopic eye. You know very well, this is myopic eye. And what is myopia? You know very well that myopia is, we have discussed many times that myopia is the increase in the plus power, right? If any eyeball got a maximum axial eye length, right, more than the normal axial eye length, and there is the plus power, if the plus power of the eyeball is more than the normal, that eye could be the myopic eye, right? And if you talk about the complaints in myopia, you know very well that myopic patient always see blurred image at far distance, right? And myopic patient will see clearer image at near. Why? We will learn about the reasons. You know very well that we will discuss that why myopic patient will see clear at distance, at far distance. The reason is very clear, because the light rays are coming from the infinity and those light rays are focused in front of the retina, right? Because why the light rays are focusing in front of the retina? For example, these light rays are coming and these light rays are focused in front of the retina here. Retina is at this point, but light rays are focusing in front of the retina. Why? Because the total power of the eyeball is increased than the normal, right? So normal power is 58 diopters of a eyeball, for example, but in myopia the plus power is more than the normal. For example, it's 60 diopters in myopia, right? So the plus power is increased. So you know very well that plus power is connected with the converging power. Plus lens mean converging lens. Plus lens always converge the light rays. The maximum, the plus power, maximum will be convergence of the light rays, right? So plus power is increasing in myopic eye, then the light rays will converge and will focus in front of the retina. So due to that focusing of the light rays in front of the retina, that will cause a blurred image at distance, because a blurred image is there on the retina. Because light rays are focusing in front of the retina, so retina got a blurred image. So that's why myopic patient will see a blurred image at distance. But in contrast, if we see that a myopic patient will enjoy a clear image at near. And why? The reason is, you know very well that whenever we see at near distance, we require accommodation. But remember that myopic patient can never accommodate. Myopic patient can never increase its plus power. What is accommodation? Accommodation is actually the increase in the plus power, right? The lens will increase its plus power. But if the patient is myope, and suppose, I suppose that, for example, but I have given the statement that myopic patient can never accommodate, myopic patient can never increase the power of the lens. For example, for the sake of learning, for example, we consider that if myopic patient can accommodate, what will happen then? Remember that the light rays are already focusing in front of the retina due to excess of plus power, due to increasing plus power. And what is accommodation? Accommodation is itself increasing in the plus power. So if, for example, myopia can increase its plus power, can accommodate, then the plus power will increase more. And when accommodation will occur, the plus power will increase more and more, and the light rays will go more in front of the retina, right? It will go towards the cornea and it will increase the myopia, right? So that's why myopic patient can never accommodate. Myopic patient, the lens of the myopic patient can never accommodate, can never increase its power, right? So as I said, that in myopia the plus power is already increased than the normal, and whenever we see at the near, we required maximum plus, we required more plus power than the normal, right? So in myopia we have already increased power, so myopic patient will see clear at near vision, right? This is reason number one. The reason number two, the far point in myopic patient, the far point is nearer to the eye, right? And what is far point? Far point is actually the farthest point in space at which a person can see any object clearly. This is called the far point. And in myopia, the far point is nearer to the eye. For example, if my myopia is -1, my far point will be here. If -2, the far point will come closer. If -3, far point will come closer. -4, -6. Increasing in the myopic power, closer will be the far point. So you know very well, far point is the point where a person can see clearly. And in myopic patient, the far point is nearer to the eye, right? So if far point is nearer to my eye, I can see, I can read my near objects or near fonts very clearly. So these are two reasons that so if we conclude that the myopic patient will observe a blurred image at far distance because light rays are not focusing on the retina, right? And myopic patient will enjoy a good vision at near distance. Why? The reason number one is, while reading we required maximum plus power, so myopia has maximum plus power than the normal. And reason number two, the far point in myopia is nearer to the eye. So due to these two reasons, myopia is enjoying a clearer image at near distance, right? So we have discussed myopia, and now we will discuss about the hypermetropia. So we conclude, in terms of myopia, we conclude two things. Myopia blurred image at distance, and number two, clear image at near, right? And number three, myopic patient cannot accommodate. So we conclude three different parameters. Number one, myopic patient will observe a blurred image at distance. Myopic patient will see clear image at near, which is a good thing. And myopic patients cannot accommodate. So these three things, right? We conclude the myopia. And now we will discuss about the hypermetropic eye. So this is a hypermetropic eye. And you know very well that what is hypermetropia? Hypermetropia, a condition of refractive error in which the plus power of the eyeball is lesser than the normal, right? So plus power is lesser, the power of the cornea is lesser, or the power of the lens is lesser than the normal, or both. Cornea and lens got the less plus power than the normal, right? So this condition of refractive error is called the hypermetropia or hyperopia, right? So let's discuss about the different complaints in hypermetropia. I'm giving my statement that in hyperopic patient, the hyperopic patient will see somehow clear image at distance. What I'm saying, hypermetropic patient, if we compare hypermetropia with myopia, the hyperopic patient will see a somehow clear image at far distance. I will tell you the reason, right? I will tell you the logics behind that. And statement number two is, my hyperopic patient will never see a clear image at near. number three, and number two, and number three is hyperopic patient will always exert accommodation. Three, I have giving my three statements. Statement number one is hyperopic patient will observe a clear image, somehow clear image at far distance as compared to the myopia. I'm not comparing it with emetropia, I'm comparing it with myopia, right? So hyperopic patient will see a clear image, somehow clear image at far distance as compared to myopia. Hyperopic patient, number two, hyperopic patient will never enjoy a clear image at near, number two. And number three is hyperopic patient will always exert accommodation. And now I'm going to prove these three statements of mine, right? So number one, hyperopic patient will see somehow clear image at distance. Why? As we have discussed about the definition of hypermetropia, in hypermetropia, patient has less plus power. Patient is in need of plus power. Patient has deficiency of plus power, right? And you know very well, there is a system, there is a phenomena inside the eyeball which is called accommodation. And what is accommodation? Eyeball can, or lens specifically, can increase its plus power whenever he needs, right? So here we have a crystalline lens over here, and because hyperopic eye has deficiency of plus power, and then to overcome that deficiency, the hyperopic patient will accommodate. It will increase its plus power, it will become more globular, and it will exert accommodation to overcome that plus power, right? So when hyperopic patient will see at far distance, he will observe blurred image, and then instantly the lens will accommodate, and that accommodation will overcome the plus power, right? It will fulfill that deficiency of the plus power, and somehow hyperopic patient will observe a clear image than the myopia. So justified. So my statement number two was the hyperopic patient will see a blurred image at near. Now we will prove it. You know very well that we always required, in normal person, we always required accommodation to see clear at near, right? If I want to see my mobile clearly, if I want to read the statement on this markers, I have to exert my accommodation to see the near font clearly, right? But hyperopic patient always has used his accommodation at far distance, because as I said, the hyperopic patient will see clear image at far distance. And why he is doing so? Because he is exerting accommodation. So he has already used accommodation at far distance, and now there is nothing for the reading. So he is unable to use accommodation at near, because he has already used accommodation at far distance. So there is nothing to use for near. So that hyperopic patient will observe a blurred, very blurred image at near, right? Statement number two is justified. And now statement number three, I said that hyperopic patient will always exert accommodation, right? It's fine, it's already clear that because there is a deficiency of plus power inside the eyeball in hyperopic eye, and to overcome that deficiency, whenever the hyperopic patient will see at far distance, right, he or she will exert accommodation every time, except he or she is sleeping, right? So we have justified the three statements. So it means that we concluded that number one, hyperopia, distance vision is somehow clear. Number two, near is totally blurred. Number three, accommodation every time. So now we will compare these three statements in hypermetropia and in myopia, you see. And now we will conclude that which is more lethal, which is in the danger of amblyopia. So first of all, we will see the myopia. Myopic patient is observing blurred image at distance. But the good thing is, this is somehow a disadvantage. Myopic patient see a blurred image at distance. This is disadvantage, fine. But the good thing is that myopic patient is not exerting accommodation. Because if you exert accommodation every time, it means that your ciliary muscle, which is involved in the accommodation, your ciliary muscles is working, is contracting every time. It means that you are going in the gym and you are exercising your only one muscles for 12 hours, for 18 hours, your bicep. Then you can imagine what will happen with your bicep muscle, right? So it means that if you myopic patient is getting blurred image, but he is not exerting any accommodation, so his ciliaris muscle is fine, there is no any symptoms, there is no any symptoms of headache and etc, right? So this is good thing. One is disadvantage, but in other case this is advantage. And next is, he is already enjoying clear image at near, so this is a big advantage. The myopic patient without any glasses, without any correction, myopic patient can see at near very clearly. And the next is, myopic patient cannot accommodate, right? So there are many good things in myopia, right? He is observing blurred image at distance, but he's not using accommodation, so his ciliaris muscle is fine, his ciliaris muscle is relaxing, so he is already getting clear image at near, right? And he is not using accommodation, so ciliaris muscle is fine. But if we compare this with hypermetropia, you see, hypermetropia, he is getting somehow clear image at distance, but with the help of accommodation. So it means that hyperopic patient is always using accommodation, right? It means that his plus his ciliary muscle or ciliaris muscle is working every time. So this extra usage of ciliaris muscle, this extra working of or contracting of the ciliaris muscle can lead towards the symptoms of the different symptoms, right? Like headache, like watering. So if we compare this with the hypermetropia, you see, the hypermetropia see clear image at far distance, so he see clear image at far distance, but with the help of the accommodation, right? But it means that hyperopic patient is exerting accommodation every time, so it means that ciliaris muscles of hyperopic patient is working, is contracting every time, so this can lead towards amblyopia, because his ciliaris muscle is under severe stress, right? Under severe contraction, right? So this is the bad thing. And the second bad thing is, hyperopic patient is not enjoying clear image at near. He will always face problems while he or she will see at near, right? But in myopia, he was enjoying the near images at near. Now the third point is accommodation. Hyperopic patient will always accommodate. He will always try to overcome the plus power, right? So it means that we have concluded that the hyperopic patient is more under the more danger, under the more, you can say, symptoms or effects of the amblyopia, right? Why? Because hypermetropia, got, he will exert accommodation every time, so one bad thing about the hypermetropia, right? And second bad thing about the hypermetropia is, he will see a blurred image at near. Second bad thing. Third bad thing is, he will always use accommodation, so his ciliaris muscle is always under stress of accommodation, under the stress of contraction every time, right? So these things, these disadvantage in hypermetropia, can lead a hyperopic patient towards amblyopia more rapidly than the myopia.